All right, we're in the kitchen of deliciousness. And of course, the combination of beef and creamy vegetables must be one of the most comforting tastes that you can experience. And today, we're going to be putting together a beef sashebo and crazy creamy pap using our DeLonghi's multi-fry. And to show us exactly how to make this Mzansi classic is legendary chef Clement Pedro.
What an intro.
You know what I mean? That's a legendary chef. Yes, you are worthy of that title, sir. And of course, to get your hands on the recipe, SMS the keyword beef to 337. To aid, remembering that SMSs will cost you around 50 and no free SMSs apply. How are you, sir?
Dude, I am amazing. Happy to always be in the kitchen with you. How are you doing?
Very, very good, thank you. I'm excited for this recipe, the end result of which looks...
But why are we making stews in November? Because Cape Town doesn't understand.
Exactly. Cape Town doesn't know from summer.
Yeah, exactly. So we're making stew and making pap, right? Because that's the mood today. Eat. You don't have to go to work anymore. When you're done eating this, you can all go home.
Just go home. Make this now for breakfast, have it, and then climb straight back into bed.
There we go. All right, let's talk about this. So yesterday we were working with the DeLonghi Ideal Fry, and we showed that the crust is a must, and you will get that with the fried chicken. Mm. Today I want to talk about the stew, okay?
Yeah.
Because we got that beautiful crust exterior, but something that can stew and cook pop and fry.
Yes, all in one.
All in one.
I thought you were going to go, because the stew is for you.
Okay.
If the crust is a must, the stew is for you.
Okay, we're going to, like, by the end of this week,
we will have
a full on track. we got to swap places, though.
Because... All right, let's get into this. Yeah,
all right, so first things first, the main difference for me between the Ideal Fry and the multi-fry is the fact that the multi-fry has a paddle on the inside.
That you can see there. So which means that it stirs
while it cooks.
Okay.
So the biggest thing when it comes to pap is the fact that you need to stand there. You can't get lumps in pap.
Nobody wants that.
So
it's smooth.
I'm going to ask you to start working on the pap. There is a bit of a method to getting the extremely creamy pap in the multi-fry. So I've got some pap over here and add a bit of salt to it. Butter.
Okay.
So if you can mix the butter and a little bit of water for me.
You know that this goes against everything I was taught as a child in making pap. Because how much water am I putting in, by the way?
Because you're going to kind of 2 to 1. So that's one part. Now you're going to eyeball it because I didn't tell you how much is in there.
Yeah, exactly.
So what are the rules when it comes to making pap?
The rules is that it literally has to burn you. Popping out of the pot while you make it, right?
And you get those pop scars on your arm.
And then the test is always, especially with my late grandmother, no flinching. When the pop pops out of the pot and it lands on you, you don't go...
What?
You must just...
That's insane. Okay, cool. That's not gonna happen anymore. Okay, so you can add more water, keep on mixing.
Okay.
While that's happening, I'm gonna talk about the fact that today we're gonna brown. You can't make a stew without browning your meat.
Yes,
first.
That's very,
very important.
How's that?
That's cool. I'm happy. We'll add a little bit of water in a little bit. But for now, can you pass me the beef? Actually, can you add the beef to our flour?
So we're gonna add the beef
to the flour. And that's going to thicken your stew.
Okay.
Right. If you want a lot of it, we're just gonna give it a good coating. So while you're doing that, I'm gonna take a little bit of your butter. You can literally see how much butter's left over.
Okay, that was nothing.
Because another thing about when it comes to air frying is the fact it's minimal oil ever used.
Okay.
If any, actually. So I want to brown the meat a little bit. That's a little bit of butter going in there. I'm liking what I'm seeing. Can I get that from you?
There you go.
There we go. So what's going to happen now, normally when you brown meat, it's very important that you get an even crust on the meat. We said it already, the crust is a must, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Cool. Now you don't just stand there and like, play Die Hard with the pot, with the meat splashing the fat back on you. No, granny, not today. So what's gonna happen is the paddle's actually gonna keep on turning the meat. It's gonna do the browning for you. So there we go, get it in there, that's enough for now.
And of course, a double heating element from above and below also ensures the even cooking, right?
And I'm actually gonna switch that on because I wanna get heat from the bottom and from the top.
Good.
That's gonna start cooking. I'm gonna put it on 4 because I want that brownness on there.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm gonna hit the magic button. That's gonna start cooking. That's all you wanna do, okay? So I'm kind of speeding the process now.
Yes.
So you wanna know when your meat's nice and brown, you normally open up the machine, right?
Yes. Don't.
No. There's got like a viewing window right in top here so you can see what's going on inside there.
I can see clearly.
Why must you stop cooking to see what's going on?
Plus you can smell it here as well.
Right.
That'll give you an indication.
So once that starts going and the meat's nice and brown, you just pop it open again and you just start adding everything. Remember the mixing's not happening anymore because the paddle's doing it all for you.
Okay.
So it's just add it, set it, and forget it.
Add it, set it, forget it.
All right,
and what are we adding to it?
Cool, some onions.
Got some onions over there.
Okay.
This is like beautiful, hearty stuff. We got some carrots.
There we go.
We've got some celery.
So basically, it's your mirepoix.
Mirepoix. Oh, that's a very fancy French word.
When my first name's actually French, so when I'm cooking, I like... do you talk to yourself when you cook? Don't you?
Do
is
I?
It only me?
I'm trying to think of where no. I do it, and I'm probably yes,
so
I do.
So my first name is French, and when I'm quick, I call myself Clément.
Clément.
What?
Yes.
There we go. Okay, Clément. So we keep on building up all those flavors and everything go. Rosemary's great. A little bit of herbage in there.
Yes.
And that goes.
It's just some water, is it?
There we go. So I've also found that people are kind of like veering away from meat a little bit. No, mm-hmm. Actually, I got enough fat in there already. So, but they kind of miss those deep, rich flavors of a stew.
Yes.
Mushrooms, when you grill them and roast them inside the air fryer,
yes,
in the multi fryer, it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
That'll give you the same kind of, obviously you don't expect the meat texture, but the meat kind of flavor you will get there with it. Because if you're going to be going, let's say plant-based, uh-huh. as most people are uh-huh. going, if you were just to exclude the meat,
exactly.
And to replace that with mushrooms, then we're getting kind of a similar kind of thing. Plus
that
it's
depth
healthy
of flavor,
well.
Absolutely. Ah, so now good. We spoke about the fact we put the machine on four, we want yes. it to brown, right? We're gonna try to, we would not try, we are gonna slow cook our stew now. So I kind of go between three and two. Two's kind of good for me right now, because it's gonna go about 45 minutes.
Okay.
Two's also good for making your pup. Uh-huh. You don't want to have a harsh heat. You don't want to get that crust. I do
yes,
like
yes.
when the pup catches on the bottom of the pot and that crispy bit of pup that uh-huh. comes with the pot.
Bojojo.
It's got a name.
Yeah, bojojo.
Whoa, okay. Yeah. But today we're going to go for the extra creamy. So literally all you do again is you make sure that your element bottom element is on.
Is on, yeah.
Just like that. You hit it and it'll start doing the magic and you're good. So
brilliant
let's
stuff.
Go. It's going to do its thing.
Then 45 minutes later. So the indicators on top there are all about the heat that you're getting.
Exactly.
So one being the lowest heat, four being the highest heat.
You set the time, you hit your elements, and it goes.
Good stuff.
It's absolutely amazing.
Fantastic.
And right now, Eskom's a serious problem. Can I say that?
Yeah.
Can I say that?
Well,
electricity.
No, we did report about it in the news.
All right,
it's fact.
Cool.
It's
so
fact.
We're trying to save electricity. What's really amazing, because again, you're cooking from the bottom, cooking from the top, with the air in there, using a lot less electricity.
Wonderful stuff. Wonderful
yeah.
stuff. Now, may we
Dude,
enter?
Please be my guest.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, get some of
I
that.
I got your pillow ready.
Papa, creamy spinach. You got my pillow ready? This is amazing.
Yeah. Would your gran be proud?
Oh, man.
Would your gran be proud?
That creamy pup is doing this. It's,
oh,
it's like
oh.
it's like dancing on my tongue, like sliding. What you got with this?
Oh, I did my job.
Up. Try that. Well done, Clément.
Thank you.
Muy bien. Anyway, we've got great news because De'Longhi has partnered with Yuppie Chef, and if you want 20% off the FH2133 or the FH1373 models, then jump onto yuppiechef.com and then use the voucher code De'Longhi20. So hurry, because there are only 40 items available at this amazing discount, and this offer is valid until the 28th of November 2019. And enjoy such beautiful deliciousness. This is great.
I'm so happy.